एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व अनदर क्वेश्चन व्हिच इज बाय मैक्सिमम स्टॉक्स इफ आई स्टॉक्स कैन बी बॉट ऑन आई टुडे। सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन देयर इज अ प्रोडक्ट विद इनफिनिट स्टॉक्स एंड द स्टॉक प्राइसेस आर गिवन फॉर एन डेज वेयर एरिया ऑफ फाइव डिनोट्स द प्राइस ऑफ द स्टॉक ऑन आई टुडे एंड देयर इज अ रूल दैट कस्टमर कैन बाय एट मोस्ट आई स्टॉक ऑन आई टुडे एंड इफ द कस्टमर हैज एन अमाउंट के इनिशियली एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड the maximum number of stocks then the customer can buy. I'll explain you further. See, these are the prices of the stocks given on different days. And these are the stocks. We have started the index from 1 because it denotes the number of days. See, this is the first day, this is the second day, and this is third day. And it also denotes the number of stocks that a customer can buy. See, a customer can buy one stock on one day, two stocks on second day, three stocks on third day, and the price of first stock or one stock is 10. On the second day, the price of one stock is 7. On third day, the price of one stock is 19. So this is the price of the stock, and these are the number of stocks that can be bought on that day, or the maximum number of stocks that can be bought on that day. I have written here. For one, maximum one stock on day one. That is, we can buy maximum one stock on day one. And for this, maximum two stock on day two. For three, three stock on day three. In the input only this is given. I have written this for the reference. Because it is written in the question that it denotes the number of stocks that can be bought. And K denotes the money that the customer has. And we have to tell the maximum number of stocks that a customer can buy. So here I have written 10, 1, 7, 2 and 19, 3. As it denotes, one stock can be bought on day 1, two stocks and three stocks. This is the cost of one stock. Okay. First is 10, then is 7, then 19. So we have to find the maximum number of stocks. So if in any question the maximum or minimum is given, then we have to apply the greedy method. And what is greedy method? Like, we have to find the maximum thing in minimum amount. Like, we have to gain maximum profit by giving very minimum. In this question, we have to find the maximum stocks that we can buy in minimum price. Okay, so first we will calculate all the stocks, the cost of all the stocks. See, in day one, we can buy maximum one stock. So 10 into 1 is equal to 1. 10 is the cost of one stock. Then 7 into 2, because 7 is the cost of one stock and maximum we can buy two stocks. So 7 into 2 is equal to 14. Now day 3, or we can buy maximum 3 stocks on day 3. So cost of one stock is 19. So the cost of 3 stock is 19 into 3, that is 57. And if we are adding all these, the answer is 81. But the cost or the money that the customer is having is 45. So we have to reduce it because it goes out of our balance. So the first thing that we have to do is sort the array or the numbers that are given, including their indexes. Now the indexes, like the numbers are sorted, then the indexes are reversed or mixed up. Like if we are sorting this array, then 7 will come first, then 10 and then 19. Sorry, I told you before that we have to sort the indexes also. We don't have to sort the indexes. We have to sort the numbers only. So after sorting, the array will look like this. And we have to keep in order the indexes also. Now what we have to do? Let's see the code also side by side. Now let's run the code. Let's give a dry run to the code. See, I have written if price into stock, price is 10 and the stock is 1. That is the maximum amount of stocks that can be purchased on day 1. So for first input, if price into stock is less than equal to K, if the amount that we have and the stock that we can buy is less than equal to the money we have. See, if we are having 10 rupees, the 10 is the cost of one stock. So the total amount is 10 and the amount we have or the money we have is 45. As 10 is less than or equal to 45, we can buy this stock, right? So we will add it in the answer. We will add the number of stocks in the answer because we have to find the number of stocks that we can buy. So 1 is the number of stock. So we will add stock into the answer. First of all, the answer is 0. So we will add 0 plus 1. This red color is the first input that I have taken for 10. So 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. That is, we can buy one stock if we are having this as input, 10 and 1. And then we have to subtract it from the total price. Like we have bought stocks worth rupees 10. So we have to subtract 10 from 45. And the answer will be 35. That is, 35 rupees are left with us now. 10, 45 minus 10 is equal to 35. That means 35 rupees are left. This is the code for this. K is equal to K minus price into stock. Price into stock is 10 into 1. So the answer is 35. Now again, we will run this if condition for the second input. That is 7. And this will be done in the sorted way. Sorry, I am going from this way. But this will happen in a sorted way. Before this, we are sorting the array. I'll do this for 7. Now for 7, the total amount that we can buy is 7 into 2 is equal to 14. 14. Okay. As 14 is less than equal to 35. The 35 is the current sum money. That is the current money we have. 7 into 2 is less than equal to 35. So we can buy that stock, right? Whole stock we can buy. 7 into 2. The cost of one stock is 7. So the cost of two stock is 14. So we can buy that stock. So we will add two stock into the answer. Because the stock is 2. The maximum stocks that we can buy is 2. So we will add 2. So 1 was the previously calculated answer. Then we will add 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3. Now we have 3 stocks that we can buy. Now we have to subtract it from our total money that we have. So 35 minus 14. 7 into 2 is 40. So it is 21. Now we have 21 rupees left. And we have to buy another stock worth rupees 19. We have to check whether we can buy all the stocks of rupees 19 or not. So 19 into 3 is 57. But we have 21 as the money. So we cannot buy the whole stocks of rupees 19. So we will divide and check how many stocks we can buy. So 21 is the money, right? So we have to divide 19 by 21. So the answer is 1. That is, we can buy only one stock of rupees 19. Then we will add one stock into the answer. So 3 was the answer. 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. So we can buy total 4 stocks taking this array as input. Now we have to subtract it from our money that we have. We had bought rupees 19 stock. One stock of rupees 19. So we will subtract it. 21 minus 19 into 1. Because we have bought only one stock of rupees 19. So 21 minus 19 is 2. And the code for this is this. Answer is equal to answer plus K divided by price. K is the money that we have currently. 19 was there. Divide by price. Price of the stock is 19. And we can buy maximum 3 stocks. But we cannot buy because the cost is going beyond the money that we have. So we have to divide it. And 1 was the answer. So we will add 3 plus 1, which is 4. Maximum 4 stocks we can buy. And the balance that we have is 2. 21 minus 19 is 2. So we cannot buy further stocks. So 4 is our answer. And the time complexity is n log n. Log n for sorting and n for the extra space that we have after storing this. We are sorting this and we are storing this. So the space complexity is O(n). O of n. And time complexity is n log n because we are running the loop till the end of the input, the whole array. N into log n. Log n for sorting and n for the whole array. Let's see the code. First, we are taking n and k as input. N is the size of the array. K is the money. So, we are taking n and k as input. Then, we are taking the array as input. Then, I have made a vector for storing the array number and index. Array number is 10 and the index is 1. We are storing indexes also. Then we are pushing back into the vector. Then we have to sort the vector. Then I have made a variable answer and made it as 0. Initialize it as 0. Then I am storing price as the first thing. See, 10,1, 7,2, 19,3. So 10 is the price and 1 is the stock. Vi dot first is price and vi dot second is stock. And then we are checking that condition I have written in the code. This one, this condition is there. If we are having the stock into price less than equal to the money that we have, then we can buy that stock and reduce the money, deduct it from the money that we have. Else we have to check how many stocks that we can buy. So we have to divide the price from our money, then we have to reduce it, and then we will give answer as the output, which will give the number of stocks. So let's run it. Three as the input. This was the example test case given in the question. See, the answer is 4. 3 is the number of prizes that are given. And 45 is the money that we have. So, we are able to buy only 4 stocks as given in the question. So, that's all for this question. I hope you understand my logic. Thank you.